The question is, what must your company do if you're being sexually harassed by a contractor, a customer, or a client of the business? I'm Jack Tuckner with Tuckner, Sipser, Weinstock, and Sipser, based in New York, and I'm an employee rights lawyer. And the question, what does your company have to do when you're being sexually harassed by a non-employee, a contractor, a client, or a customer, is they must treat that sexually harassing, offending client or customer just as they would an employee who is sexually harassing you. In other words, they must investigate your complaint of gender or sex discrimination, because that's what it is. You're being objectified, sexualized, treated differently, dealing with unwelcome sexual attention at work. Doesn't matter that it's not your manager. Doesn't matter that it's not a colleague. If it's a customer who comes in who is targeting you, your employer must investigate it and correct it. They are responsible for preventing it. And they're not allowed to treat you worse because the customer or client is worth more to them financially than you are. If they do that, and that happened right now in a current case that we're dealing with, where a customer that pays a lot of money regularly went to this store, which is part of a larger corporate chain, sexually harassed our client, and when she complained about it, they essentially told her, that's right, he's important to us, deal with it. In fact, if you don't want to deal with him, we're going to transfer you to a much more distant location. That's illegal. That's sex discrimination. That's retaliation in that case for her protected complaint. So if a customer, client, or contractor in your work environment, in your workplace, is sexually harassing you, make sure that you put the balls in your employer's court and complain about it. Don't quit. Don't run off and go file a complaint somewhere yet. Put it in writing, document it, and let your employer do what it's supposed to do first. Because if they resolve it in your favor, then it's all good. And you'll have your written complaint as protection in case things happen or go south thereafter. This is Jack Tuckner with Tuckner, Sipser, Weinstock, and Sipser. If you have any questions about your own case or a loved one's workplace situation, feel free to contact me, Jack Tuckner, or Deborah Orell by phone or by email, and we'll set up a consultation where we brainstorm with you in total confidence.